morning. Welcome to chapel this morning. We are very pleased to welcome back Father John again this morning. Father John from St. Joseph Catholic Church, thank you for your message this morning. And many thanks to the Catholic Student Organization for their leadership and hospitality, especially Michaela and Madison this morning, who will be reading and praying. With that, I invite you to stand and invite up Father John.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you and with your spirit. Good morning to every one of you. Let us feel the presence of God as we gather in the name of Jesus. As Jesus said, where two or three are gathered in my name, I am in your midst. The presence of Jesus is with us. Let us praise him, adore him, glorify him, worship him through this song. Once again, I welcome all of you for this chapel. Feel the presence of God by listening to the word of God. Please sit and listen.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to all the congregation of the people of Israel and say to them, 'You shall be holy, for I, the Lord your God, am holy.' When you reap the harvest of your land, you shall not reap to the very edges of your field, or gather the gleanings of your harvest. You shall not strip your vineyard bare, or gather the fallen grapes of your vineyard. You shall leave them for the poor and the alien. I am the Lord your God. You shall not steal, you shall not deal falsely, and you shall not lie to one another, and you shall not swear falsely by my name, profaning the name of your God. I am the Lord. You shall not defraud your neighbor. You shall not steal. And you shall not keep for yourself the wages of a laborer until morning. You shall not revile the deaf or put a stumbling block before the blind. You shall fear your God. I am the Lord. You shall not render an unjust judgment. You shall not be partial to the poor or defer to the great. With justice you shall judge your neighbor. You shall not go around as a slanderer among your people, and you shall not profit by the blood of your neighbor. I am the Lord. You shall not hate in your heart any one of your kin. You shall reprove your neighbor, or you will incur guilt yourself. You shall not take vengeance or bear a grudge against any of your people, but you shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Please stand for the acclamation. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to the disciples, "You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. But I say to you, do not resist an evildoer. But if anyone strikes you on the right cheek, turn the other also. And if anyone wants you to sue you and take your coat and give your cloak as well. And if anyone forces you to go 1 mile, go also the second mile. Give to everyone who begs from you, and do not refuse anyone who wants to borrow from you. You have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, so that you may be children of your heavenly Father in heaven. For he makes his sun rise on the evil and on the good, and sends rain on the righteous and on the unrighteous. For if you love those who love you, what reward do you have? Do not even the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet only your brothers and sisters, what more are you doing than others? Do not even the Gentiles do the same? Be perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I feel this place is holy, holy and holy. You know, that's wonderful words we saw in the outside. Holy and holy, yeah. Today, as I am thinking, the gospel and the first reading today, God calls us for holiness. Holiness. In the book of Leviticus, God speaks to Moses and gives the Ten Commandments. The commandments of God are intended and determined and given to Moses and all the people to make the people holy in wholeness. Jesus also, today in the Gospel, describing the Old Testament law, and he is giving the New Testament, his own commandments, the loving commandments, to make us holy and make us our relationship very strong with God and the people. That's why Jesus is today, you know, by saying this, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, so that you may be children of your Father in heaven. Jesus wants us to be the real children of God, Father in heaven. If you and I want to become the real children of God, we should follow the commandments of God. We should follow the commandments of God. You know, just he ends the gospel with, be perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect. Jesus wants us to be perfect like the heavenly Father. But nobody can be perfect in this world. We are all human beings. But Jesus is aiming at, he regards us in a high standard. He wants us to be like him, to be perfect in all things, whatever we do, whatever we think, whatever we speak, whatever we see, everything. Jesus wants us to be perfect like Heavenly Father. That we cannot, as a human beings, we cannot be like God, but we can aim it, we can take effort to be perfect. That's what Jesus wants us to make effort. It's not an easy thing, but it's a lifelong effort, lifelong journey that we should make effort to be holy, to be perfect like our Heavenly Father. That is the desire and that is the aim of Jesus today. That's what he calls us this morning, my dear friends. Jesus wants us to. And also, he says, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. That is really touching, you know. Pray for those who persecute you. If I do that, if I really practice that one in my life, there will be no enemies in the world. There will be no fight between one country to another country. There will be no enmity between any other nations in the world. Everything will be as Jesus like. You know, in the early church, I think that, if I do that, it is really makes me to lead a life of saints. In the early church, so many saints, they were simply killed. They were simply persecuted. They were, you know, the... If I take the life of St. Lawrence, you know, in the early church, we know everybody, the St. Lawrence. He's a deacon. He was a deacon. He was working with the Pope. And when the time of persecution comes, they wanted to take all the properties of the church. This deacon sold all the properties and gave to the poor. And they came and asked, where is your property? He showed the people, they are my property. They got him, put him into the jail. And what they did, you know, they put him into the boiled oil and took him out and grilled him, roasted him on the grill. While he was on the grill, he was telling the people, oh, my one side is burnt. Turn me other side also, so that other side also will be burnt. I will be one with God in my sufferings. They accepted the suffering. They accepted the persecution in the name of Jesus because they were praying for those who are persecuting them, you know. They accepted that. They never thought about taking revenge upon them. They didn't ask any, why you are killing me, why you are persecuting. They didn't ask anything, but they accepted sufferings and pain. They were simply praying for the people. You know, in that way, Jesus is not exemption from this one. Jesus, what he said, he practiced in his life. We know that Jesus, he was insulted greatly by crowning him by thorns and taking him to walk with the cross and killing him on the cross. It was a great insult for him. He never speak any word about why you are making me, why you are killing me, why, you know, he did the same thing. He was praying for the people, those who are killing him. You know, that is the way Jesus wants us to lead. Pray for the people, those who are persecuting you. Love your enemies. That's why he is God. That's why he is God. That's why all the saints, we are praising them. You know, another thing, if somebody strikes you on right one side of the cheek, if you show another cheek, in this world, if I and you do that, people will laugh at us. Oh, what? Are you the fool? Do you not know what you are doing? If somebody hits you on one cheek, if you show another cheek, they will mock at us. But if you are foolish in the world, we will be wise men in heaven. We will be wise men in heaven. That's what Jesus calls us today, my dear friends. Jesus wants us to be holy. Jesus loved everybody. There is no partial love. He loved the sinners, he loved the good people. He loved everybody so that the rain is falling for all the people. Jesus wants us to do that likewise. Love everybody because our God is so merciful, so kind, so loving. He doesn't like us to hate anybody, forsake anybody, to abandon anybody. Jesus wants us to love all the people, whether he is Christian, whether he is Hindus, whether he is Muslim, Islam, or whether he is a Lutheran or Catholic, all the people. God wants us to love everybody as he loves. Amen. Please stand for the prayers. Let us offer our prayers into the loving hands of God.
Let us pray for the whole people of God and for all people according to their needs. For harmony among nations and for leaders of government, that all may work for universal peace and prosperity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all people, as God's human family here on earth, that we be open to the grace of God's merciful, loving presence within us, and extend that family-like love to one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this family of faith, may we have humble hearts that ask forgiveness of God and neighbor, and courageous hearts to give forgiveness when asked of us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, despite our culture of competition and consumerism, may we learn to live our lives with simplicity, generosity, humility, and modesty. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick in mind and body, and those suffering from grief, loneliness, poverty, addiction, and desperation, may their lives be redeemed from destruction and be crowned with God's kindness and compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy and grace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So now we say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Just for a second, as we are in the presence of God, let us close our eyes, close our hands, feel the presence of Jesus among us. Feel that Jesus is standing in front of us and is sending his Holy Spirit among us so that we may be kindled by the fire of the Holy Spirit. We may be filled with the graces and blessing of the Holy Spirit. Aviyanavare ennaiyakkida எனக்குள் இருக்கும் இறைவனின் ஆவியாரே என் மீது அசைவாடுமே, இன்று என் மீது அசைவாடுமே. தேங்க்யூ ஜீசஸ், தேங்க்யூ ஜீசஸ் ஃபார் யுவர் பிரசன்ஸ், தேங்க்யூ ஜீசஸ் ஃபார் த பவர் ஆஃப் த ஹோலி ஸ்பிரிட், தேங்க்யூ. த லார்ட் பி வித் யூ. May Almighty God bless us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us joyfully sing the sending
all the world.
Thanks be to God.
Only I'd like to thank the, the president and the pastors who have given me this nice opportunity to be with this with you all of and share my thoughts about the gospel and praying together. That's a great nice. I am really happy about that. Thank you so much. And also I would like to thank Sean Erickson, our coordinator, and Madison, Michaela, Emily, and Leanne, and all the people, those who work for this chapel. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Bye.